Okay, so this is going to be the last part of this tutorial. What we need to do is to display our results. Okay, so for now we have optimized our model. We need also to display our results. Okay, so from here, if you want to display the results, it's simple. Let's go here to reports. Let me select this reports. If you can see here, we have several options here, but the one that we are going to use is this items results and not the flex table. So flex table we are going to cover it in another tutorial. For now, let me start with, I want to display the link results or properties, and for links we are going here to pipes. If I click this, you can see this is the table that we are having. So from here, let's say, so you can see this are the diameter, this is the Hazen Williams, and this is the calculated flow, I think, and also this is the length. So let's say I want to copy these values and insert on your let's say on Excel. What you can do is to click this on this empty cell here, and from here is to click this copy with header. Of course you can use copy, or I prefer to use copy with headers. Then you just open your Excel, there you have it. And again, the other option, so let's say I close this, and I want to display the junctions values. This is what we are having. Again, if you want to copy the values, you can just copy and then select this one here, and then copy with headers. So if I, as soon as I click a copy with headers, my values are copied within the clipboard. So if I copy with headers and I go back here, let me click this and paste. These are the values. And again, if I close this, what next? Okay, so the next thing that I want to share with you is, let's select this pressure pipes. Okay, so this is what we have it. So from here you can get a clear picture of the pipe length that you need for your project. Okay, so let me click, so if you can see, this is the 50 millimeter dia pipe, and if you can see here, so the 50 millimeter dia pipe, you can see the length here is 50 meters, and for PVC pipes the length is this one, and for DI pipes it seems as though we don't have any pipe in this region. And again, the length for steel is this one, so steel with this diameter is this one, and again the steel with 75 diameter, this is the value. So this is very helpful, especially when you have like a big project, you want to simplify your work for quantity takeoffs, especially for quantity surveying people. Okay, so this is very helpful. But if you want, let's say, to export your results, what I can do is to click this print preview. I'll just click it. It is going to generate report. Then this is your values. So if you can see the diameter, 75 diameter, we have a PVC, this value, and also the DI for 75, we have this value, but for 50 millimeter, it seems as though we don't have anything on DI pipes, and also these values here. So this is the total length. So if someone, let's say, ask you what is the total length for your project, then this is the length. What is the total length for 75 PVC and DI pipes and is also steel, this is the total value, and so on and so forth. So if you want to save this, of course you can just click file, then export either as CSV or as PDF. There you have it. So this is the first tutorial on WaterGEMS. In the coming tutorials, I'm going to cover in deep on each and every topic related to WaterGEMS. So make sure that you subscribe if you haven't. Make sure that you hit that like button to help me to reach more people like you here on YouTube. And lastly, don't forget to share with your friend. With that being said, I will see you in the next video. Thank you.